Bonjour à tous. Quelques mots en français tout d'abord pour vous souhaiter la bienvenue à Paris au nom de la maire de Paris et de son équipe dans laquelle effectivement j'occupe des responsabilités en matière de modernisation de l'administration. Vous souhaitez une très belle conférence et comme nous essayons de nous mettre au niveau des standards internationaux, je vais faire le mot d'accueil in English en vous demandant beaucoup de tolérance et de patience pour ce propos introductif. Donc merci à tous. Je vais essayer dans cette présentation de rappeler les grandes lignes stratégiques de la ville de Paris en matière de e-government et de modernisation notamment des services numériques et comment la transformation numérique bouleverse les organisations publiques et au premier chef les villes, notamment comme Paris. Since 2002, the city of Paris has been developing five-year IT master plans in order to provide efficient information storage, transport and processing infrastructures for its specialist departments and support services, as well as a very high-speed broadband network covering all of our sites. These projects have allowed us to cope with a huge increase to uses while controlling the operating expenses. The digital revolution is completely changing user expectations and the production of public policies. All of Paris city departments and district town halls now share the same tools for managing support functions. The implementation of these overarching information systems and the associated dematerialization of processes has helped to achieve greater gains in efficiency and performance. Virtually all of the professional sectors involved in the management of public spaces, cultural, sports, and educational facilities, as well as the early childhood and social services departments, are now computerized for the benefit of professionals and users. Over 100 teleservices have been deployed and are therefore helping to simplify procedures for users. Further improvements are expected to follow, particularly in order to adapt our internal procedures. The organization of information systems will be further improved and employees will be trained how to use these powerful and sometimes complex tools. But the real aim of our new action plan for 2020 is to develop our digital services no longer by profession and therefore in a vertical manner, but in a comprehensive and uniform way. In 2015, the city embarked on a new cycle characterized by maturity and greater expectations concerning digital technology. The Digital City Master Plan must therefore focus on developing and improving the service that the information system provides for its different internal or external users. This measure encourages the emergence of new services for the benefit of users at a controlled cost. The City of Paris will be devoting 200 million euros for this project between now and 2020. Paris's digital strategy can be defined by three courses of action. First of all, digital services bring together the online applications and procedures offered to users and the city's employees. These services simplify and speed up their actions, disseminate precisely targeted information, and reduce the risk of errors and wasted time. Secondly, intelligent infrastructures are intended to support the city's technical infrastructure in order to promote access to digital services for Parisians, but also to feedback information to the city's departments about the use of the services provided for users throughout the entire area. And finally, the core information system, a series of maintained and upgradable technical and functional systems, the true foundation of the digital city, which allow for the emergence of the services divided from the three aforementioned courses of action. To offer users a high-quality service, the city's employees and elected representatives need to be working with the right tools. This means providing them with the tools and information to support the development of their activities. Simplifying access to the information system, especially for front office employees of district town halls, developing mobile versions of certain business applications, electronic signatures to facilitate the dematerialization of processes, mapping tools and decision support dashboards for elected representatives. Equipping specialist functions that do not yet have satisfactory information systems, for example, property, budget preparation, healthcare facility. Better management of public spaces with the development of the unified geographical information system covering the metropolis. Continuing to improve the efficiency of support functions by opening up certain applications for mobile uses, improving the ergonomics of information systems to facilitate their adoption by city employees, and continuing with the dematerialization of processes, strengthening our management and evaluation capabilities by developing decision-making tools. Our aim is to develop responsible and sustainable IT, reduce IT ownership costs, and optimize resources, notably through optimized cloud use, enhance the existing assets and develop uses, including those with an outward focus. Another central issue on which we are working, which is of a philosophical as well as a technological nature, relates to the digital identity of citizens. Regulators have neglected this topic for too long, leaving private companies with a virtual monopoly of online digital identities. Although we are not advocating a state monopoly on digital identities, it is clear for us that the development of e-government practices requires to lend credibility to the security and verification of digital identities, especially in the current climate of widespread insecurity. For the city of Paris, digital technology must improve the accessibility, quality, and efficiency of its public services. Paris has a duty to develop a range of efficient, simple, and accessible digital public services, which put the user right at the heart of the process, with three major focuses. Firstly, the development of digital services allowing quick and uninterrupted access to connected Parisians, thereby limiting their need to make unnecessary journeys. In addition to the new Paris.fr website, which was redesigned in June 2015, and the development of its applications, we have launched 53 new digital services for Parisians since the beginning of the mandate, and some 30 new digital services accessible via Paris.fr will be launched in 2016-17. A digital account for a unified and simplified means to access to digital municipal services will then be created in June 2017, called My Account. It's a personal space on Paris.fr. All of the teleservices will be gradually integrated into the My Account space by 2018. At the same time, the Paris Citizen Card is ultimately intended to replace all of the cards required by users of the city's public services. This is a powerful way to simplify public services, and its popularity is illustrated by the fact that more than 150,000 cards have already been issued. Finally, because digital technology is not the most appropriate solution for nearly 20% of the public service users, we are developing our physical reception and support services in order to reach the people that struggle to access public services. This involves supporting users in their online actions, what we call digital facilitation, but also adapting the geographical availability of reception and information areas in order to make them more accessible to the most vulnerable groups. Digital technology does not only help to improve our internal workings and dematerialize existing public services in order to make them more accessible to users. In a social context of mistrust in politicians, who are often accused of losing touch with citizens, the emergence of the new tools and uses that accompany digital technology can potentially revolutionize ways of designing public services and help to renew democratic practices. Through these new tools and uses, digital technology can make the operation of public institutions accessible to citizens. This is known as open government. It is the idea of increasing the involvement of citizens in designing public services. This participatory approach has become an essential component of our approach to modernizing our administration. A prerequisite to this democratization of the administrative function is transparency. This is why, as part of our open data policy, we have published budget data and human resource data online. In addition to this, we are specifically involving Parisians in our decisions. The local authority is attentive to the needs of the Parisians and listens to their innovative ideas. From 16 December to 2 October 2016, the citizens of Paris were invited to vote on the participatory budget, and nearly 160,000 Parisians took part in this vote. This administrative revolution was accompanied by the distribution of a guide to civic participation in order to promote the adoption of ways to involve Parisians in the cities project throughout all of the city's departments. The overall success of the ID.Paris IDS platform demonstrates the extent of this democratic revival. The website has become a hotbed of Parisian democracy by hosting 17 ideation campaigns since its launch in January 2015. Although digital technology allows institutions to develop a more open approach towards their citizens, it also allows these citizens to develop their own tools to help them play an active role in public affairs. Online petition platforms, online digital spaces for dialogue and reflection, and political campaign comparators are just some of the multitude of tools being created every day by politically committed citizens wishing to use technology for the common good. The development of civic tech demonstrates the renewed appetite of citizens to become involved in society. It is also an opportunity to renew the conventional democratic choices by drawing inspiration from its horizontal, open, and innovative model. The increasing success of Civic Hall also illustrates the desire to seize the concrete and immediate opportunities for universal civic engagement. In recent years, Paris has become one of the world's biggest magnets for startups and other digital stakeholders. Parisian stakeholders in civic tech have naturally emerged from this fertile breeding ground. We aim to make Paris an international benchmark ecosystem for civic tech. As a sign of its commitment to this field, the City of Paris will host the Open Government Partnership Summit in December 2016, a multilateral initiative bringing together more than 70 countries and aiming to obtain concrete commitments from governments in terms of transparency, the empowerment of citizens, the fight against corruption, and the use of new technologies to improve governance. The 2016 OGP World Summit will be held in Paris, France, from 7 to 9 December. For the first time, territorial authorities will be invited to present their work, thoughts, and local commitments to encouraging democratic inclusion and transparency. Last year, major cities worldwide showed their willingness to become leading players in the fight against climate change. They are now proving to be genuine breeding grounds for new democratic practices. Digital technology is the common tool of these two dynamics of open government and civic tech. It is a tool that they share in their convergence on the issues of public affairs and the common interest. Paris City Hall is currently working on creating a meeting place for this convergence, a civic hall. This will not be an incubator, a business hub, or a fab lab, as such places already exist. Nor will it be a civic hall as in New York, which is restricted to civic tech entrepreneurs. as we want to create a place that reflects a strong French tradition of public service. House Civic Hall will be a space for meetings and exchanges between Parisians, civic tech stakeholders, elected representatives, public officials, and all the networks and stakeholders involved in the issue of using digital technology to serve the common interest. A revolution is underway. Like all revolutions, it is driven by optimism, but it also has a darker side. Devising a system of e-government, as you are invited to do by the work program of this conference, is an obvious way to provide proof of concept of the beneficial effects of the digital transformation for our societies. The people of Paris need this. On behalf of the mayor of Paris, Anne Hidalgo, I would like to wish you a very successful conference and an excellent stay in Paris. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Are you able to take a few questions? Perfect, if you join me here. Thank you. So, as a reminder, if there are any questions from the audience, please, somebody should be coming around collecting those, I hope. Not at all, Bob. So, just in case of need for. So, the first question I had was, how did you decide which services were the priority for modernization and transformation?
Je peux dire en français.
Of course.
Tout simplement les services sur lesquels nous avons des sollicitations quantitativement les plus importantes, considérant que c'était celles-là qui étaient les priorités en termes de développement de services.
Okay, those are basically
we need a mic.
It's more important for you.
There's no worries, worries.
Basically, did they sort out the services, and those were the most important and could quantitatively basically contribute from a business value and also from a cost point of view. They were basically prioritized for digitization.
Yeah. Thank you. Next question just arrived. What cities or digital government implementations does Paris regard as models of e-government services, and where do you look for e-government innovation?
Alors, tout d'abord, nous regardons. Alors, nous, en réalité, nous étudions toutes les grandes métropoles mondiales, parce que je ne crois pas qu'il y ait de modèle unique, et donc nous nous inspirons de tout ce qui se fait de bien, et je crois que c'est une pratique qui est commune maintenant aux grandes villes. Mais c'est vrai que nous avons des liens de proximité plus particuliers parce que il y a des angles politiques qui nous sont proches. C'est vrai que nous travaillons beaucoup avec New York, avec Londres et avec certaines villes canadiennes. Et puis de plus en plus avec des villes européennes en matière de budget participatif, par exemple Berlin et l'Espagne.
Basically, they did a survey of all the other global countries. They basically took a look at other ones in Europe as well as in the United States, such as New York, and other cities in Canada. And they wanted to take a look and see what model would be most appropriate for Paris.
Okay, thank you. Long question, but it's one question. Given a Paris citizen, how can a user get a listing of all services available, pick the ones that they want, and be sure that despite the complexity of services the user has asked, the services are correct, available, and working as they should? And there's an example given in the question. I moved into a new Paris flat. I need water, trash, electricity, and school for my young children. I pay taxes and voter registrations, and I want to volunteer my IT skills. Do I need individual services, or is each one separate?
Alors, c'est un très bon exemple et un très bon et aussi une bonne illustration de ce vers quoi nous voulons aller.
La première chose, c'est que tous les sujets que vous évoquez, les sujets très concrets, ne dépendent pas de la même entité administrative. D'ailleurs, j'ai le sentiment que ce n'est pas le cas dans les autres pays non plus. C'est-à-dire que pour l'électricité, pour l'eau, vous avez forcément des contacts. Mais pour revenir sur ce qui est du cœur de compétence d'une ville comme Paris, effectivement, aujourd'hui, vous continuez à avoir une organisation par silo, une organisation très séparée par secteur. Et c'est ce vers quoi on veut tendre, c'est l'unicité d'accès dans lequel, via un accès notamment numérique unique, eh bien, vous pourrez accéder à l'ensemble des services qui seront offerts par la mairie d'un seul coup.
At this particular point of time, the services are still organized on an organization by organization program. It's a pull system. He's looking at potentially with single sign-on to go to more of a life event-based system where, for example, if you move in somewhere, you can have a consolidated set of services. In the meantime, there is guidance for people that are logging in to basically access all the services. And with single sign-on coming in, you said in July of 2017?
Yes.
I think what happens, that'll basically facilitate access to services on a consistent basis. There will be guidance on it. Organizationally, the social innovation portion still has some room to move, to grow, shall we say.
Perfect, thank you. Did you use any standard maturity model to measure the maturity of digitalization?
It's more a question for the IT department.
Right. It is a bit technical.
Ils essayent de travailler de cette façon. Moi, ce n'est pas mon rôle. Moi, je suis un élu. Mais ce que je leur demande, c'est de déployer des outils d'évaluation des politiques publiques dans lesquels des références à des standards internationaux de digitalization, etc., sont des éléments effectivement centraux.
Basically, the maturity models are used mainly within the CIO group and is based on international standards. And he wanted to be, and what happens is, what he wants is to, from an open data and transparency point of view, is have them publicly available so people can essentially see how mature and how the organizations are moving forward.
Great, thank you. Two more questions, if I may. One is, you mentioned the idea of digital facilitation for, I think you said about 20% of the community. Can you say a little more about how that works or what is involved?
Oui, alors il y a deux éléments. Tout d'abord, un qui concerne les taux d'équipement des usagers. Et contrairement à ce qu'on pense, le taux de pénétration du numérique, y compris dans les classes populaires, est très fort. Mais ce n'est généralement pas avec un ordinateur fixe, mais de plus en plus avec un smartphone. Et donc ça nécessite qu'il y ait une priorisation de développement de services sur smartphone. Je compléterai après.
Okay, essentially what happens is they take a look at the digital revolution. What they're looking at is providing services on mobile applications because they figure that's right now where most people have them available to them on an ongoing basis.
Et le deuxième élément, c'est qu'il y a parmi la population une partie qui est radicalement rétive à l'utilisation des technologies pour différentes raisons. Raisons culturelles, linguistiques, d'éducation, etc. Et je crois que l'un des enjeux de l'accélération de la transformation numérique, c'est précisément de simplifier pour la grande masse des usagers, de réduire les coûts pour la grande masse des usagers et pour pouvoir justement réorienter une partie du service public vers des publics plus fragiles qui auront besoin d'accompagnement. Et pour ça, on a besoin de former nos agents à l'utilisation des outils et on assiste à un phénomène de convergence qui est celui des applications métiers et de leur volet présentation pour les usagers, de sorte qu'un agent peut remplir à la place d'un usager l'interface, c'est le même outil.
They're looking right now, there are certain client segments that are not very prone to using digitization. And right now what they're looking at is basically is making sure that all the service providers within the city are cognizant of that and that they have training programs as well as provide capabilities so that this client segment can basically take advantage of the services in varying degrees.
Oui, ça va. Merci. Last question. The Open Group is a partner in an EU project called Biotope. It's with cities including Lyon. The project is exploring smart city use cases using Open Group standards. Is there a network in which Paris works with other cities in France or e-government and its use of smart technology and network within France?
Oui, alors c'est vrai que la ville de Paris, comme d'autres villes européennes, ont eu tendance à travailler un peu seules. Et donc, de plus en plus, nous essayons de développer des programmes en commun. Et donc, notamment parce que les financements européens imposent de travailler en réseau. Et pour donner des exemples précis en matière de Smart City, nous avons toute une politique de développement de l'utilisation des objets connectés dans la ville et de l'utilisation des capteurs et des objets connectés au service des politiques publiques en matière de lutte contre la pollution, de trafic automobile, d'utilisation des équipements publics.
Okay, right now what happens is that initially Paris started off and working as usual, you know, as typically alone, but now they're working more and more in cooperation to have common services. They're leveraging the Internet of Things as well as to basically to integrate sensors and the like to participate in activities such as pollution control and the like. For that, they are working with other communities.
Did you mention?
Non, je vais donner des exemples. Oui.
Okay, this, and alors, he'll give examples.
Yes.
Now.
For example, on travaille avec la ville de Lyon et de Marseille sur les échanges d'informations d'identité sur les actes d'état civil. Hein, c'est la transformation numérique de l'état civil.
Okay, he's working with Marseille and Lyon right now to share identity management services.
Oui, et on a un très grand programme européen de lutte contre la pollution avec des villes italiennes, françaises, anglaises, allemandes, espagnoles sur l'utilisation des capteurs en contrôle de pollution atmosphérique et de pollution sonore.
He's right now working with a European organization that's working to counter pollution. He's in conjunction with cities, for example, in Italy and the like, with an emphasis being on sensors that are basically gauging the pollution and subsequent controls that we put in place.
Et bientôt, on travaillera plus avec l'Open Group.
Merci beaucoup.
Merci.
So thank you very much, Deputy Mayor Emmanuel Gregoire. Thank you very much for sharing your experiences here in Paris. And we're very happy to have you here and a great way to start our conference. So
thank you very much.